Good morning, students. Today we are going to study the new topics. The topic name is team formation and its properties. In this unit we discuss about the main components of this topic, the contents, the formation of team, advantages of superheated team, enthalpy of team, dryness fraction, specific volume of water and steam, specific volume of superheated steam, entropy and numerical. So today we'll discuss about the steam formation. So we'll discuss the introduction of that one. The steam is nothing but the steam is generated from the boiler section. That is, the boiler means nothing but the closed vessel in which the steam is generated by the evaporation of water. The steam is utilized for external purposes for to generate electricity. That is, the important part of the steam is a working flow. Then we'll discuss about what is the formation of steam generated. Then go to the introduction part, how to develop the steam. The first of all, steam, which is gaseous from pure water, is an excellent working medium in a various thermodynamic system because of the following properties. It has many properties, and in this case what happens, steam is generated from the pure water and steam utilized for the thermodynamic system. Why? Because it has certain characteristics, certain qualities. First one, it can carry large quantity of heat. Second, produce water which is cheap and readily available, and it can be used for heating purposes. It can be purely as heating medium in food processing industries because of fast, easily controllable and hygienic method of the heating. That means we have discussed the four point in this. What happens, the steam has a various applications, steam has a various uses. Therefore the steam has taken for this unit. So how to generate the steam, the formation of steam? The formation of steam is nothing but the boiling. The steam is generated from the boiling of water, and steam form at a higher pressure, at a higher temperature, and it can be flow through insulated pipe from steam generated to the point of use. Then what are the terminology used in the steam formation? There are so many terminologies. First one, sensible heat taken by ice, latent heat of fusion, sensible heat taken by water, latent heat of evaporation, sensible heat taken by steam, then specific enthalpy of water, specific enthalpy of saturated water, latent heat of evaporation, specific enthalpy of dry saturated steam, specific enthalpy of super heated steam. And then these are the terms are used in the steam formation. And we discuss about the advantages of the super heated steam. The steam has three types. One is the wet steam, dry steam, superheated steam. So what are the importance of, what is the significance of superheated steam? So we discuss the first one. The superheated steam can be considerably cooled during expansion in an engine cylinder before its temperature falls so low as to cause condensation on cylinder walls, which is direct heat loss. The second, temperature of superheated steam being higher, it gives the higher thermal efficiency. That means superheated steam gives the higher thermal efficiency, the most important parameter. And then it has a high content, high capacity of doing work, results in the economy of steam thermal. That means superheated steam has various advantages. One is it gives the improve the thermal efficiency of the engine, and then you have to minimize the fuel economy. Then discuss about the enthalpy of steam, because there are different types of terminology used in the steam formation. You have to study in detail. The enthalpy of steam, nothing but the enthalpy of 1 kg of water or steam is called specific enthalpy. That is, the enthalpy of 1 kg of water or enthalpy of 1 kg of steam known as the specific enthalpy. Then discuss about the specific enthalpy of unsaturated water. It is simply what is about the amount of heat required to the temperature of 1 kg of water from 0 degrees Celsius to the actual temperature, which is below the its saturation temperature. That means this specific enthalpy that means to raise the temperature from 1 kg of water from 0 degrees Celsius to a certain degree temperature. This is not the specific enthalpy of the unsaturated water. That means if the water is present at a temperature below the boiling point or saturation temperature, it is called unsaturated water. That is, the water is present below the boiling point is known as the unsaturated water. The water is present at above the boiling point, that is known as the called saturated water. at its boiling point. Then discuss about the specific enthalpy of saturated water. Again, the same condition, the heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water at 0 degrees Celsius to its boiling point corresponding to the pressure applied. It is given by the HR. From this above 0 degrees Celsius, again from ice, and this 0 degrees Celsius, 1 kg of water. Then latent heat of steam. What is the latent heat of steam by HFG? The quantity of heat required to convert 1 kg of water at its boiling point into dry saturated steam. That means you have to convert the water into dry saturated steam, and it is known as the latent heat of steam, HFG. It is denoted by the HFG. Then discuss about the wet and dry steam. The wet steam means nothing but the sum water particles are present. That is, wet steam is the steam in which the whole water has not vaporized. Complete water is not vaporized. Complete water is not converted into the steam, but the sum vaporized water is present in the form of mist, fog suspended in the completely vaporized water or steam. Due to this, the mist, the wet steam is visible. That means, in wet steam means the sum water particles present in the steam is known as the wet steam. Then how it draws steam? In which vaporization of complete is invisible, colorless. Any steam which is completely dry and present at saturation temperature is called steam. A dry saturated steam, that means there is no water particles are present, only the dry saturated steam is there. Water particles are offset. Then go to the another parameter, dryness fraction. Dryness fraction is nothing but the ratio of weight of the dry steam actually present to the weight of total waste steam which contain it. It is denoted by the X. That means how much amount of dry steam divided by the how much amount of waste steam. The ratio of that, that is the weight of dry steam to the weight of moist steam or waste steam. That it indicates the dryness, the quality of steam, quality of the steam. Dryness fraction is the quality of steam. Take discuss here. The dryness fraction is 0 for saturated water, that is the saturated water, and the 1 is for dry saturated steam. Then discuss about the another parameter, specific enthalpy of waste steam. That means the quantity of heat required to convert 1 kg of degree Celsius ice, degree Celsius, into waste steam of a given quality at a constant pressure. That means for the constant pressure, you have to convert the water into the wet steam. This is the specific enthalpy of waste steam. But in the case of dry saturated steam, the quantity of heat required to convert the water into the dry saturated, in this case dry saturated, or in this case wet steam. There is a difference. Again, the constant pressure is there. At a constant pressure. Then discuss about the next point, the specific enthalpy of superheated steam. Again, the quantity of heat required to convert the 1 kg of water. This is the superheated steam. This is the wet steam, dry steam, and the superheated steam. Again, the at a given temperature and pressure is denoted by the SU. Then specific volume of water or steam. That means the volume of unit mass of water is known as specific volume. The unit mass of water or steam is its specific volume. Then discuss about another parameter, the specific volume of saturated water, VF. Again, the volume of 1 kg, volume of 1 kg of water corresponds to the pressure. The volume of water at a given correspond to the given pressure is known as the specific volume of saturated water. The specific volume of the dry saturated steam, that is VG. The volume of 1 kg of dry saturated steam corresponds to the pressure in the VG. In this case, again, at given pressure, 1 kg of dry saturated steam and 1 kg of water, this is the difference. Then specific volume of the superheated steam, VSU. The 1 kg of steam converted superheated steam, and it can be defined by the assumption that the steam behaves as a perfect gas. The steam behaves as a perfect gas in a way. The gas law, it is equal to VSU. Then discuss the last parameter, we discuss the entropy of steam. The entropy of steam means specific entropy of saturated water. Again, what happens in this case? The specific entropy of saturated water at a particular pressure P, saturated temperature T, is the change in entropy during evaporation of 1 kg of water at 0 degrees Celsius into saturated water as its pressure. That means whenever the conversion takes place by 0 degrees Celsius to the saturated water, and that change is nothing but known as considered as the specific entropy of the saturated water. Then discuss about the change specific entropy during evaporation. It is given by the latent heat of water, the heat added. Then discuss the specific entropy of disaturated steam. What happens? The 1 kg of disaturated steam and given some of the entropy, 1 kg of water entropy change during evaporation given by G. Specific entropy of the wet steam. That is, in this case, what happened? The 1 kg of disaturated steam. In this case, wet steam, that means the wet steam, specific entropy of the wet steam is equal to the sum of the specific entropy of water plus and change in specific entropy during the evaporation of dry saturated steam. There is a discussion between the dry fraction of steam and wet fraction of steam. Then, specific entropy of super steam. Again, the same case, sum of specific entropy of dry steam plus entropy change to the superheating. Then the duration to be considered, what are the changes occur in between them? The entropy change during superheating. Then we are cover the theoretical portion of this topic and then go to the numerical part of it. So today we will take the numericals based on this steam formation. The first one, calculate the total heat of 5 kg of steam at a pressure of 9.8 bar having dryness fraction 0.8. Also calculate the heat in kilojoule required to convert the steam into dry and saturated steam. First of all, you have to identify the numerical. In this numerical, what is given? Because the steam, total heat of 5 kg of steam is given. 5 kg of steam having a pressure, having a dryness fraction, and you have to calculate heat is required to convert the steam into dry saturated steam. That means this numerical you have to convert. The steam is there from 5 kg of steam is there, and what is the importance? You have to how much amount of energy is required to convert the steam into dry saturated steam. This is the question arises in this case. The first of all, you have to use the steam table. The from steam table, you have to factor 8 bar pressure. You have to find out the properties of this steam, HF equal to this one, HFG and HG. From this value, you have to calculate the enthalpy of this steam. HF equal to HF plus XHFG, put the values. You will get the values enthalpy 2358.1 kJ per kg. This is for 1 kg. And in this numerical given the 5 kg. Therefore, total heat of 5 kg of steam, you have to multiply this enthalpy. You will get the final value 11790.5 kJ per kg. Kilojoule. This is the energy required, and then from this equation you have to find out total heat of 5 kg dry saturated steam. Dry saturated steam, that means the HG is given 2761.4 kilojoule per kg. You have to multiply by 5, you will get 13830 kilojoule. Then you have to determine the net heat required. The net heat required to supply for conversion of waste steam into dry steam. Our major objective is the how to convert the waste steam into the dry saturated steam. Therefore, that you have to remove the moisture content. Then you have to find, you have to minus these values from this one. The net heat required to supply for conversion of waste steam to dry steam, you will get 2039.5 kilojoule. 2039.5 kilojoule amount of heat is required to convert the steam into the dry steam. This is the end of the first numerical. We go to the another numerical, the second numerical. The second numerical is given 4 kg of 0.5 dry steam at 6 bar pressure is heated. So that it becomes, first one, 0.95 dry at 6 bar pressure. Second, dry and saturated at 6 bar. Third, superheated to 300 degrees Celsius at 6 bar. And superheated to 250 degrees Celsius at 8 bar. Using steam tables, determine in each case the quantity of heat required to be supplied. Take C soup for superheated steam as 2.3 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So first of all, you have to again read the numerical and you have to determine what is the given in the numerical input data. So first of all, the steam is given dry saturated. Steam has a divided the three parts. One is the wet steam, dry steam, and super steam. So this numerical belong to dry steam. In this case, and then you have to find another parameter. In this case, the steam conditions are different. The 4 kg of steam is given in this case having a dryness fraction at 6 bar pressure. Then you have to find out in this case, find out how much heat, quantity of heat required needed for the 4 parameters. One is the 0.95 at 6 bar, second dry saturated 6 bar, superheated condition and superheated condition, two conditions given to be different. Then first of all, you have to use the steam table. Then initial condition of steam, mass of steam is given 4 kg. Dryness fraction x1 equal 0.5, the pressure is given 6 bar, and you have to go to the steam table, find out the values. Then you have to find the h1, and h1 equal to hfg, put the formula and put the values from the steam table. 6 bar pressure, value of specific enthalpy of said water hf and latent heat of hfg is given. This data is taken from the steam table. Then put this one, the equation, this above equation, will get the h1. So h1 is 6852. H1 equal to enthalpy 6852 kilojoule you are getting. Then heat supply, because you have to find out the heat supply at the different conditions A, B, C, D. Then first of all, first condition, case 1, supply the final condition of steam x2 equal to 0.95, P equal to 6 bar, final enthalpy is given. Again, they put the values in the formula, put the values, will get the 10605 kilojoule. Then you have to find the net heat supply. Then it's applied equal to final enthalpy. Final enthalpy minus this one. H2 minus H1 will get the 3753 kilojoule. Second condition, final condition is the steam or pressure 6 bar, and condition dryness fraction is 1. Before that, dryness fraction is 0.95. This is the difference. And then you have to apply the formula H2 HG, put the values, will get the values from steam table H2. Then again you have to final enthalpy minus initial enthalpy, and this is the H2 minus H1. You will get 11022 minus 6852, you will get the 4170 kilojoule heat is needed, heat supplied. Case number 3, final condition steam in this case 6 bar and superheated condition, temperature is different, 300 degrees Celsius. The form steam table, again go to steam table, you have to find out the temperature 3000 degrees Celsius, you have to note the temperature, find the enthalpy of superheated super steam, S2 equal to M, HG, CPH, T super, T sat, is the formula, put the value, you will get the value 12321 kilojoule. Then you have to again minus final enthalpy minus initial enthalpy, S2 minus H1. And 12,321 minus 6,852 will get the 5,469 kilojoule. This is the needed supply, the third condition. Then last parameter, final condition. In this case, pressure is different, 8 bar. Before is the 6 bar, the 8 bar. Temperature 300 degrees is the previous temperature. Previous parameter, in this case, you have taken the 250 degrees Celsius. And find the value from steam table where 8 bar. You will get in TS temperature and HG temperature, HG values. Put the formula S2 equal to M, HG plus CPS, T sub, T sat. Put this formula useful for the super testing. So you will get 11,802 kilojoule. Then again, minus final enthalpy minus initial enthalpy, will get 11,802 minus 6,852, will get the 4,950 kilojoule with the heat supply at the fourth condition. And in this case, we are in this numerical, you are only the main condition, you have to, these conditions given, different conditions given, you have to find the heat supply, that is H2 minus H1. And then go to the another numerical, third numerical. The third numerical based upon the entropy. Calculate the entropy and the volume of 4.73 kg of superheated steam at a pressure 7.8 bar and temperature 240 degrees Celsius. Take Cp for superheated steam 2.32 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. This numerical belong to the entropy, steam formation, volume is given, pressure is given, temperature is given, and Cp for superheated steam is given. And you have to find entropy, that is the main entropy to be find out, SF. The first of all, you go to the 7.8 bar from the steam table, you have to calculate the values from the steam table, and then 250 degrees Celsius, apply this formula, T is V super, you have to find the specific volume of super steam. Apply this formula Vg into Tc upon Ts, you will get 0.254 meter cube per kg. So you are getting the specific volume of super steam, you are finding out for 4.73 kg of steam, because steam kg is given. The mass of steam is given, 4.73. You have to multiply it. You will get, then multiply it, you will find out the total volume of 4.73 kg of steam will be the 1.3498 meter cube. Then find out the specific entropy of superheated steam. Then find out the specific entropy. Specific entropy of superheated steam. You have to put the formula Hg plus C sub log E T sub upon T. Then you have to put the value. You will get 7.0115 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Then you are getting the total entropy. But you have to find out the total entropy for the 4.73 kg. Then this multiply the 4.73. So you will get total entropy of steam 33.16 kilojoule per Kelvin. Then the third numerical belongs to the entropy. In this case, what happened? In this case, you have to find out the from pressure line parameters involved, enthalpy, entropy, and then put the apply the formula for the superheated steam, and you will get final value total entropy of steam 33.16 kilojoule per Kelvin. Then last numerical to be taken for the today's session. A boiler is producing steam at a pressure of 15 bar and quality as 0.98 dry. It was observed that while flowing from boiler to the place of heating through pipes, steam losses 20 kg of heat per kg, assuming the constant pressure. While flowing through pipeline, calculate the quality of steam at the place of heating. Again, this numerical belongs to the steam formation. What is given in this case? The boiler is producing steam. That means the boiler generating steam having a pressure 15 bar, having a dryness fraction 0.98, and it was observed that it is flowing from boiler to the heating through pipes. When the steam is flowing through pipes, what happens? The steam heat rejected by steam 20 kJ of heat per kg. Assuming the constant pressure, while the flowing through the heat pipe, they calculate the quality of steam at the place of heating. That means the steam is generated in the boiler and the steam is passing through the pipe. You have to determine some heat loss takes place, and you have to determine the quality of steam at the place of heating. Whenever the steam is heated, that time what is the quality of steam? That means you have to find out the dryness fraction in this case. Quality of steam means what is it mean? Whenever at the time of heating, what is the quality of steam? That dryness fraction. So first of all, you go to the 15 bar. Having dryness fraction 0.98, heat loss is given 21. You have from steam table P1 equal to 15 bar. You have to find out the values H1, HFG. Then find out the enthalpy of the H1, HFG plus XHFG. Put the values. You will get the 2751 kJ per kg. Then heat loss 21 kJ per kg. Then you have to minus from this H1. That is the enthalpy 21. You will get 2730 kJ per kg. That is the enthalpy. The net enthalpy of steam at the other end of pipe or at the place of heating. Then you have to find dryness fraction. The dryness fraction of steam is the H2, that is the enthalpy 2, H2 equal to H2, H2 HFG, this is the formula. Put the values and you will get the values of H2. The H2 will be, put the all these values, will be, H2 will be 0.97. That is the, that means in this case, what happening in this case, you have to determine, you have to finding out the equations involved in this case, what is that means, how much amount of dryness fraction is present is there. This is the end of the fourth numerical. And we'll take the last numerical discuss here. In this case, in a conical process where a batch of 50 kg of milk initially at a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius is to be boiled at atmospheric pressure until they concentrated to a final mass of 40 kg, calculate the mass of steam consumed to carry out the process if the steam is supplied in a dry surface condition at a gauge pressure of 1 bar and condensate outlet is at 100 degrees Celsius, assume 20% of useful heat loss in the vat. Again, in this case, the one conical vat of the batch, 50 kg of milk is there, having 25 degrees Celsius, is boiled to the 40 kg of, to the 40 kg. Calculate the mass of steam consumed to carry out the process. Whenever the mass of mass of milk is there 50 kg. Even the heat is supplied, that time the mass of milk is will be 40 kg. So what is this? So that means in this catastrophic condition, consider having the pressure of one outlet consumption is 100 degrees Celsius. Find out this useful heat loss. That means in this case you have to find out the useful heat loss, how much amount of heat is utilized to convert 50 kg to 40 kg. The first step was sensible heat of by the heat absorbed by the milk. You have to MCP delta T. You have to formula this, put the value formula and put the values. You will get the sensible heat of absorbed by the milk. 15,900 kilojoule. Then mass of water evaporate from the milk, 50 minus 40, 10 kg. Then latent heat of evaporation water at atmosphere from the steam table, you are getting the value 2 to 5 kilojoule. Then latent heat of evaporation for 10 kg of water, multiply by 10, you will get this one. Total heat consumed in the process, addition of this one, 1500 plus 22,570 equal to 38,470 kilojoule. Then you have to define absolute pressure of steam supply, 1.013 plus 1 equal to 2.013 bar. And again go to steam table, you have to find the value Hg and Hf. And then net heat by the 1 kg of steam. You have to minus this one, 2707 minus 419.1, you will get. Then in this case, in numerical 20% heat loss to be considered. Then 20%, you have to multiply this. You will get the net heat given by the steam to milk, 1830.30 kilojoule per kg. And then finally, you have to determine steam consumed to supply total heat required in the process. That means you have to convert the steam. You have to convert the 50 kg of milk to the 40 kg of milk. So how much amount of heat is required? That means you have to divide it, 38,470 divided by 1830. You will get a 21 kg. That means in this case, what happened? In this case, you have to determine. In this case, what is happening in the case? Calculate the mass of steam consumed. That is the final 21 kg of mass of consumed in this numerical. This is the end of the today's session.